Hey, Bears fans, the NFL trade deadline came and went, and, well, there were no moves made by Ryan Pace, and the Bears should Pace be fired for not trading for an offensive lineman. Type Y for yes, type N for no. I want 1,000-plus comments on today's video, so get your votes in. Should he be fired for not trading for an offensive lineman? Y for yes, N for no. This O-line looking like a disaster for this week's game. More on that later in the show. But first, the latest Bears news and rumors, starting with the quarterback position. Should Mitchell Trubisky start? Well, Dan Orlovsky of ESPN thinks so. They debated this on Get Up just yesterday on ESPN. Nick Foles versus Mitchell Trubisky. There was a debate. Mina Kimes thinks they should stay with Nick Foles. Dan Orlovsky says, no, you got to go back to Mitch. Foles is 2-3 since taking over as a starter. A lot to dissect. I know a lot of you guys have been wanting Trubisky to get back into the lineup as well. Let me get this bigger quote from Orlovsky here, saying Mitchell Trubisky gives them the best option. He will cover up the two main deficiencies that they have: a poor offensive line because of his athleticism and an average skill group because of his athleticism. Go back to Mitch Trubisky. First of all, I think this skill group's a little above average. You have a true number one receiver and a good running back, but that's neither here nor there. You look at these two quarterbacks, though. Obviously, these are two less than average options, right? Like Trubisky, not a good pocket passer, offers you more mobility, can create some things, but certainly does not diagnose coverages very well. Nick Foles, better at identifying defenses, but he's stiff, he's not mobile, this offensive line stinks like we've talked about, and he's not the best decision maker. So you're dealing really with two backup quarterbacks, if we're being completely honest. I have more thoughts on this in a second, plus the latest rumors about what the Bears think about what they should do at quarterback. But first, get subscribed, and thank you to everybody who is already subscribed. We just crossed 16,000 subscribers here on Chicago Bears. Now, let's get to 20K. Let's keep the momentum rolling. Let's have some fun. I'm posting videos every single day now, basically, here on Chicago Bears. Now, I want to hit 20K by the end of the year. It's a lofty goal. Can we do it? I think we can do it with your help. So hit that big red button and share that link with a Bears buddy, youtube.com/bearsnow. Now, the Bears side of this appears to be that they're going to stick with Nick Foles. And based on what Matt Nagy has said and now what Dan Graziano of ESPN is reporting, that basically they feel like the Trubisky experiment is over, that they gave it their best shot. He started for the past 2.5, almost 3 years. And that's the reason they made the change, because there wasn't improvement. If anything, there was regression after a somewhat breakout 2018 season. They feel like Nick Foles gives them the best chance to win. And more than anything, it just kind of sounds like they've moved on. They didn't opt into his fifth-year option this offseason for a reason. They let him start the year, did not play well in that Falcons game, gave him the hook, and they have not looked back since then. Here's Graziano on the Bears' outlook of this. They feel like that ship has sailed, and they think they have done everything they could do with him, and that Nick Foles is their best chance going forward, at least for this season, I assume, is what he is talking about there. Look, could you talk me into a situation where Mitchell Trubisky could be better behind a bad offensive line? Maybe, but marginally, right? He's not the long-term option in Chicago for this offense, so why not see what Nick Foles can do? It's been a smaller sample size. Either way, this offense stinks. We know that. The O-line sucks. Both quarterbacks have been bad at times. Trubisky was up and down in his few starts. Nick Foles is certainly up and down within every single game, by the way. Had great moments against the Saints, had bad moments against the Saints. This offense has to score more points. I'll let you guys answer the question, who should start? This will be the pinned comment on today's video. Nick Foles or Mitchell Trubisky? If you think it's Foles, type NF. If you think it's Trubisky, type MT. Go ahead and cast your votes in the comments. Remember, 1,000 comments on today's show, so debate down in the comments section. In some Bears news, Ted Ginn Jr. has been released. I called this last week, and not surprising, right? Because once they signed Dwayne Harris to the practice squad and he was promoted last week for punt returning duties, the writing was on the wall. We saw this coming. I knew as soon as that Monday night game against the Rams was over and he was a disaster as a punt returner, literally would not catch the ball, I was like, he's done. because he's not playing at receiver. He's not getting snaps there, and he won't catch on punt. He's giving you nothing in the return game, so why keep Ted Ginn around? Sure, you know, they've said good things about him as a veteran and whatnot, but he's their number five receiver. Like, what's his real value? And now it looks like we'll get to see some Riley Ridley, too, with Javon Wims being suspended. So Ginn is gone. I would expect Dwayne Harris to be activated to the 53-man roster. Technically, he has not been yet as we film this, but that'll probably happen very, very soon. He'll be your punt returner and probably like your, you know, emergency number five type of receiver, as Ted Ginn is now been released. All right, Bears fans, we got a mailbag coming up very, very soon, sometime in the next few days. So use hashtag Bears to get your questions in. Hashtag Bears, ask whatever question you want, and I will answer as many of them as I can. Best questions get answered, so go ahead and get them going down in the comments section. Today's show presented by Bet Rivers, our sports betting partner here on Chicago Bears. Now, you can get 100% deposit match at chatsports.com/betil or chatsports.com/betin. You're probably asking, why two different links? Here's the deal. You can deposit and sign up from anywhere, but to actually place a bet, you must be either in the state of Illinois or in the state of Indiana. So state of Indiana, chatsports.com/betin. State of Illinois, chatsports.com/betil. They'll give you that 100% deposit bonus up to $250. And if you want to bet on the Bears this week, I like the under against Tennessee. I've already put some money down, 46.5. That feels a little high for this one. Titans, 5.5-point favorites at home. We'll see how this one plays out. Go bet this weekend at Bet Rivers. Get going. Again, state of Indiana, chatsports.com/betin. And then the state of Illinois, of course, is chatsports.com/betil. But you can deposit from anywhere. And then once you're in one of those states, you can start betting at Bet Rivers. All right, I teased at the beginning of the show, as if this offensive line wasn't a big enough disaster, it's even more of one with Jason Spriggs testing positive for COVID-19. He will not play this week, barring, you know, a false positive result coming out, but I don't think that is the case here. He was expected to start at right tackle for Bobby Massie, who is now injured. He's going to miss at least one game, possibly two, because this takes, you know, 10 to 14 days. We're kind of right on that fringe of the COVID protocols here, so we will see what happens, you know, for next week, but he's going to miss this week's game. Oh, and great, Germain Ifedi was in close contact with him. He's on the COVID-19 list. Now, he could play this week. It's contact tracing. This is protocol for the NFL. If he gets a negative test or two, should be good to go for Sunday's game, but certainly not a given and not a good situation. I mentioned Bobby Massie. We talked about him on yesterday's show. He's officially been placed on IR. He will miss the next 3 weeks. Two games, bye week. Hopefully he can come back for the game right after that. Oh, and guess what? Sam Mustipher is hurt too, the backup center, really the third string center, because James Daniels was your backup center and your starting left guard. He's already out for the season from 3 weeks ago. Like, how concerned are you on a scale of 1 to 10 about this offensive line for Sunday? I'm at about a 74. Like, this is a disaster. This group already stinks up front, and now you're telling me that you're going to have to play a bunch of backups and practice squad guys? That's bad. Don't start David Montgomery in your fantasy league this week. Scale it from 1 to 10. How concerned are you for this game with this offensive line? I'm over a 10. I'm at about a 74, like I said. I don't know how they're going to block anybody. Lachavious Simmons was activated from the practice squad, seventh-round rookie. He's almost guaranteed to start unless Ifedi is ready to go. Maybe miraculously Cody Whitehair gets ready for Sunday, but he's still dealing with a calf injury. I don't think that's very likely. Look at this depth chart. Look at this. Look at the amount of asterisks on screen. They have two guys on the COVID list. Spriggs is not going to play. Ifedi, I'd say 50-50. He actually probably will play. But as of now, if everything goes wrong, this is probably your starting five. Charles Leno, your only day one starter at left tackle. Rookie seventh rounder Arlington Ambright at left guard. Alex Barrs probably at center. Lachavious Simmons at right guard, who you just called up. And then Rashad Coward, who's horrible, will have to be your right tackle. And then you'll have to call up a practice squad guy. This is a disaster if you are the Chicago Bears with this offensive line. Ryan Pace should have traded for an offensive lineman. He refused to do it. I don't know what the issue is. That's a big, fat problem. If you want more videos, subscribe to Chicago Bears now. Just hit this button and check out our video from yesterday right here. Just click that button. Bear down. We'll see you next time.